You've built a superb sheet, dashboard, report, or template, and it's time to make sure your team, stakeholders, or clients see your work. After all, sharing is caring. When you share in Smartsheet, you not only show that you care, you make the latest version of your work available in real time to your collaborators. In this video, you'll learn how to share Smartsheet items, the ins and outs of your permission levels, and some best practices for both. You can either share to an individual person's email address, or you can share to a Smartsheet group that's been created. When you share an item, any individual emails and Smartsheet groups that have already been added in your contacts lists will display automatically. And you can choose from three different permission levels: viewer, editor, or admin. Let's go through those real quick. Viewers can access all the information in a sheet, but can't make any edits or changes. This makes sure the info in your sheet isn't accidentally changed or deleted. If you pick editor, they can edit the sheet and add files and comments, but can't modify the column layout. Perfect for getting the right input from the right people. There are two types of editor permissions: editors who can share the sheet to others and editors who can't. Lastly, the admin role allows collaborators with their own Smartsheet license to add or remove collaborators, change permissions, and modify the content and structure of the sheet. This role is great for your closest collaborators or team members who co-own the project the sheet supports. Once you've entered your collaborators' email addresses, it's a best practice to add an optional message to the invite details explaining what you're sharing with the others. You can update the subject line of your sharing message, which is especially helpful if you're sharing with team members brand new to Smartsheet. You can change the default view of the sheet and include a shared filter. This ensures that collaborators see a specific view of the information in your sheet. When you share, the person will get an email with a link to the shared sheet and can then go directly to the sheet if they have a Smartsheet account. If your collaborator is new to Smartsheet, we'll ask them to pick a password and create a free user account in order to view your work. The sharing indicator shows who is viewing your sheet and lets you know when the changes have been made. We also have some alternate ways to share a snippet of info without sharing your whole sheet. For sharing selected items, you can select a single or multiple rows, select the row menu icon, then the send option to share with people via email. If you want to send specific columns in your sheet rather than the entire row, you can use the edit option and select the relevant columns to include in the email. To share a static view of your entire sheet, you can go to the file to send it as a PDF or Excel file attachment. You can also publish your sheet and share it in real time with viewers without requiring them to log in. Great for when people need quick access to your sheet's info. A workspace is a useful place where you can bundle sheets, reports, templates, and dashboards. You can share workspaces with people just like that. This way, you can share all relevant items with the same group of people. When new items are added to the workspace, they'll automatically inherit the sharing permissions, color scheme, and branding applied to that workspace, so the workspace is consistent. You can also share individual sheets within a workspace. And that's sharing in a nutshell, and how Smartsheet makes it easy to collaborate in real time so your team can get things done together. To learn more about sharing and other options, visit the Smartsheet Help and Learning Center.